Okay, today I want to talk about magazines, or lack thereof. this is pretty much the magazines I have for this rifle. And really, I have loaded magazines in all my other AKs. And those are my other magazines. And I also just have these three magazines sitting around. Two of them are loaded. I try to have as many loaded magazines as I can. This one's empty. Right here, I have three magazines right here in the pouch. Good idea. And obviously I need a lot more magazines. Over here I have two magazines for my Glock 21. You never know. I also have a smaller magazine for my AK, which I don't really count, but there you go. But anyway, definitely need to get more magazines. This is a Yugo magazine. It's different because it actually holds open the bolt carrier. After you fire the last round, this, you can see the difference between this and a normal one. It has a lift right here that stops the bolt from really continuing. Whereas with a standard European one, it doesn't have that lift. You know, you don't really see it there. So I haven't really got a chance to really try this out because when I first, this actually came with this Yugo rifle, and I had a breaking in period, had a lot of growing pains. Wasted a lot of gas driving back and forth to the range. I think I drove like 35 miles to the range, then another 35 miles back home. I had to manually break it in. Then I did that two other times. So I drove a long distance to get that rifle to the point where it's broken in and it was working reliably. I didn't really mess around with this Yugo magazine too much because I was so busy using the magazines I knew worked on all the other rifles. This is another magazine that came with it. This is a Tabco magazine, which you guys know I don't really care too much about it. I don't have a lot of experience with it, so maybe I'll get around to using it.
Look at the type of magazines I received from sgammo.com. Seems to be in pretty good shape. Pretty affordable. Yeah, I need to buy a lot more magazines. I can definitely tell that this is made of a sort of a different paint than this one, but they all seem to be in good shape. I'm not too picky about the magazines. I like the durability that you get with magazines like these. So, like I told you guys before, I'm gonna separate these from the magazines I know that work and just make sure that these magazines work. And once they've been cleared, then I'll introduce them to the pile. But you never want to just buy new magazines and throw them in with everything else until you've actually tested them out and you know that they actually work. It's a very important thing because you could be dealing with a magazine with a weak spring. It could be a number of issues. You know, it could be a lot of dirt in there, a lot of cosmoline that's slowing down the action, preventing the follower from really coming up. So you got to keep that in mind. All right, question of the day. How many magazines do you think someone should have in preparation for some type of serious security problem, whether it be SHTF or whatever? See, I think the more magazines you have, the more likely you're going to have access to a magazine if something goes down. You know, if you just have a small amount of magazines, they may be located in a limited amount of areas. So I think by having more, it'll be more helpful. My immediate goal is definitely to have at least five magazines per gun. And I would sort of work from there and at least get up. By the end of the year, I want to at least have 10 or so magazines for every single rifle I have. And I also expand beyond the AK. I'm going to try to get myself a 308. I've actually been working on it, getting myself a PCR 308. I know I've said it in the past, but I'm actually working towards it now. So leave your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.